I don't know if they're that the prohibitive favorite, but they're certainly one of the favorites to win the gold medal in the doubles here at the World Championships.
Last one.
So here we go. You don't see this matchup all the time. You've got one of the elite defenders in the women's game here in Soo Hyo-won, the Republic of Korea, up against the Olympic single silver medalist, the second seed here in Houston, Sun Yingsha of China. It's going to take a set beforehand. And sometimes you take a little bit of adjustment here. You come from playing Adriana Diaz and indeed the doubles that Sun played earlier. Playing more orthodox attackers, shake hand attackers, and then you come in and play Sir. Just take a little bit of time to get to grips with that.
As we've seen before with these Chinese players, you've got to get out into a lead early if you do want to take one of them down. And so gets an early lead, but see how Sun Yingsha adapts going forward.
An awful lot of that particular pattern of play here with Sun winding up and then of course going into the forehand side of Sir.
It's a good example for people who are new to the sport of the chopper style, the way they slice it, both on the forehand and on the backhand side. It's amazing sometimes to watch these choppers get balls back on the table you think are dead, and they are able to dig them out and get them back on.
Let. 4-2.
Seems like the assistant umpire may have called that let, and not exactly sure what the problem. Not sure if you saw anything there, guy. That was...
5-2.
Obviously, it's an extremely high toss serve that she's using on the backhand side. It does have to go essentially vertical.
It. You do get the attacks, of course, of the chopper off the forehand side. Sun was waiting for it there.
All she had to do was put the paddle on it. Nice block right back to the open table.
Oh.
Was that a behind the back shot there by Sun? It looked like it. See if we get another look at this.
Actually in the women's game, it's really just Soo Hyo-won, and you have Han Ying, the German as well, but she's a little bit more now, I would say, a bit of a hybrid defender. You have on the men's side, you've got Ruin Phyllis. I'm sure a lot of this crowd have seen this sort of style before. You can tell from the reactions, they're loving these early exchanges. It's just so different to those who aren't watching week to week. I mean, they're just enjoying these rallies.
That's what we're saying. We've seen so many different styles tonight, and this is a completely different one. But it is impressive to see these choppers get the ball back on the table when you think there's absolutely no hope. And as you said, Guy, an attack from the forehand side.
Oh, you will see that. You will see that from the from an elite chopper. It's about choosing the moment, and she got it just right there, sir.
Good job of digging that one right off the body.
There we go. That's the frustration. This is the thing as well for Sun Ying Sha. Anyone coming up against an elite chopper like this, it's just the concentration level is required, point after point here. And eventually, even Sun has lost patience. You're seeing ball after ball coming back with heavy backspin.
I think Sun's just going to get her workout tonight. Make sure that she gets all of her strokes in.
It is fascinating, as you say, Mark, because you don't see this matchup all the time. And that's the thing. The crowd we've got here, got a mixture of the table tennis community. Then you've got people obviously trying to bring the sport out to a new audience as well. Just don't see this.
Yeah, it's interesting. We had the match Kanakja versus Felis from Germany, as a defender as well. I talked with the commentator Barbara Way about it, and she seemed to think that, and her opinion was that you can kind of tell by personality who the defensive style players are going to be in the gym. You can say this person fits that mold. It is kind of something that a certain type of person is going to be drawn towards. And if it works for you, well, then why not? 9-8. And on the flip side, Guy, I would imagine if you're playing a defensive player, conditioning is going to be a factor, because if they can draw you into a 6 or 7 game match, your ability to stay aggressive, to stay energetic through the entire match is going to be a challenge.
Game points here for the second seed. Off and running here. The opening game is hers. Yep.
Love one. fault to love to below the planning surface.
The toss obviously has to come from above the table surface.
It's got to be visible. That's the whole point, the toss. So she's lost the point there. The umpires are giving a warning, but then they are stepping in. And that's what's happened. Susurt there. That's clever, isn't it? Merely concentrating on heavy backspin. Actually, very difficult for Sun to attack off that. Get the timing right off the backspin. It's a demanding style of play. Back to your point, Mark, about that with Sohyeowon, who's, you know, at the end of the day, top 25 in the world doing this, but it's extremely demanding on your body to play this week to week, this style of play.
I was going to say the same thing. Practicing this style on a day-to-day basis, it's a miracle you don't get carpal tunnel syndrome, for crying out loud. You're constantly making the same motion again and again and again. And the mentality, the mental approach to it, to me, is even more interesting. The fact that you're willing to say, you know what, I'm going to hang around on this point as long as I need to until I can either make an attack or my opponent's going to make a mistake, one of the two.
Getting the balance right here, Sun. Not obviously trying to be aggressive, but not going for too much early on, looking to build. I think that's the same principle here. You know, our commentary colleague Jimmy Butler's been making that point a number of times this week through the draw. You know, about building a point, not looking to go too early. A lot of the pros try and finish. I mean, he just finished that point early, but to go, he believes, too early too often. It's actually just better to build a point against a chopper, clearly.
It's a completely valid point, and I thought that one example that you're referencing here is it was a progressive move forward towards the table by Sun Yin-Cha. She was willing to loop from pretty deep off the table on the first one, take a step up, loop another one, take a step up. All of a sudden, she's on top of the table, the ball pops up, and bam! She smashes it there. She built that point.
Seven, three.
Break here, second of the second game. Now, very impressed with Sun Yin-Cha here so far. Extremely tricky opponent.
You know, I don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves, but the winner of this quarterfinal will play Wang Yidi. So I'd be fascinated to see that matchup. And I'm not saying, I mean, I'm not taking Su out of this match too early. I hope people don't think that. I just am fascinated because of the quality of consistency of those two players. how the term I would use, you know, referencing kind of other sports, is solid. They're very consistent. They're not flashy. They're not necessarily something you'd say, you know, that would immediately catch your eye. But they're subtly great, is what I would say.
Been about stories this week. That was another one where table tennis was at the forefront of efforts in the world to make the world a better place. Unified Korean team. She was part of it, bronze medal there. Seo-hyun Won brings a lot of experience in, also a bronze medalist at the Team World Cup the following year. I was there actually in Tokyo, and they won the bronze medal.
We referenced it earlier, but the sport has something about it that does bring people together. It even at your local club, Dan, you know, if you don't play and wanted to go, you could walk into any city in America, if you're listening here in the States, there's probably a club locally, and you would be immediately accepted. There's something very communal about this sport, whether it's on a global level or on a local level. So it is very unique in that way, and of course, we've referenced it as well. Anybody can play it. You could go down to your club tomorrow and play this chopping style and drive everybody nuts, for crying out loud.
Such a good blend that Sun Ying Sha's got going at the moment. Mentioned it earlier how difficult mentally it is. Actually, I remember the interview with Wang Manyu when she came up against Chopper as well. These younger players actually find it a little bit more difficult, you know, mentally with that, the application. But
they want it done right now, guy. If you don't have a young child, if you do at some point, you'll figure that one out. If it ain't happening right now, we're very frustrated. So a chopping style doesn't really fit with Twitter, if you know what I mean. Save on the backhand side by Sue. It shows the skill level it takes to play this style.
For sure. Kept this point alive for so long.
Fault was called again, probably for the same thing that we saw earlier.
Yep.
The ball not being visible to the opponent on the toss. The fans don't like it, obviously.
We're going to go timeout here. Yeah, she's been called for it again while she's lost the point. I just wondered whether her coach, she was wondering whether she wanted to call the timeout there. And continue.
It may have rattled her a little bit there.
It's difficult. Any player, when they're called for that, you lose the point, but also as well, just unsettles the rhythm. And more than anyone, a chopper is about, Mary Chops is about generating rhythm, starting from the service.
And if we've learned anything at this tournament, you can't give away any points to any member who's in the red and gold, okay? You just cannot give them any points.
Two, eight.
block.
And the crowd really appreciating this effort from Sir here. That is, as you say, a super block. Oh, back edge.
9-3.
And Ruth will look down at the back of the table there from Sir.
Even the choppers can't get that one.
No. The idea there.
I liked it.
Came with the short,
very
aggressive. With the forehand flick, yeah. It's 6 game points now for Sun. Yeah, and then he needs the one. Whips that away. Top of the game, winning all the prizes. In the end there on the top of the bounce. Just started the match. Since then, of course, Sun Yung Sharp possessing beautiful timing and shot selection.
Still somewhat fascinated by the decision of a player to go to this style. You know, whether it's a coach who comes to you saying, you know what, this is going to be your best chance, or whether it's internally you say, this is the way I feel I'm most comfortable playing. I'd love to interview a couple of choppers and kind of go through that history and how it came about, because it has to start, I would imagine, at a relatively young age. And to make a decision as a young person that this is the way I'm going to play this sport going forward in my career, because this is the way I enjoy, I'm presuming they enjoy to play from this manner. So it says a lot about the individual. I'm fascinated about that process.
Read the flatter block there really well, Sun, on that occasion. Look at it again here. A good counter quickly across.
One, four.
On your point, Mark, you know, on that. With Sir, when she was interviewed about it, we've got a timeout here. Just no issues really after the first few points. How she's managing it, the blend.
4-2.
You win the point out of the timeout. Paid off.
Five, two.
It just underlines how Sun Ying Sha has handled the challenge here tonight. Even the touch of the tape there, immaculate.
Very
business-like. These attacks, yeah, all business. Backspin.
Timeout's working relatively well.
Heading into the second towel break. The game here.
Right into the body. That's perfectly on the left elbow right there. Aggressive posture that time from Sun Yu Cha. Didn't back down at all on that one.
As you call it in these parts. Just doesn't sound authentic, does it, from a Brit, that? I'll leave it there.
Yeah, we don't see much of that in football, your type of football, I guess.
So good, the application from Sun here. Everything that we've seen, just after those first few points, really, where she just took a few points to settle in. After that, it's been so impressive.
Tremendous reflexes. Great block that time by Sun Ying Sha. And she is on the verge of moving to the semifinals against her teammate.
Indeed, already through to the semis of the mixed doubles with Wang Chuqin, the women's doubles with Wang Manyu. Now on the brink here in the singles.
Pretty good tournament, eh?
10.
Yeah.
Timeout.
Now a timeout here. Will the timeout do the trick for Sun here? Second match point.
It does.
It does. Sha Sha, Sun Ying Sha, remaining on course for a triple crown here. In